Thanks for checking out my video. If you want to learn more from me, I have a lot of classes on Udemy. You can find the links to a lot of those in the description.
Alrighty. Hey guys, so I'm planning on making two videos today. You might see me shift and wiggle around a little bit because I'm actually suffering from some lower back pain. I sprained something and I strained something else. So I'm in a little bit of a conundrum. But one of the things that I wanted to talk about while I'm recording two videos, anyways, is meditation and sensory deprivation or sensory overload. Now, these kinds of things can really, really help you get into meditation. It may work for some, it may not work for other people, but I've tried them at various points, and there's several times when some things have worked and some things haven't worked. So it kind of can depend on the person, and it can even depend on mood. So if you've ever heard of like meditation cabinets, these things are crazy, right? It's like a box that you close yourself into, and maybe you're sitting like, you know, crisscross applesauce. I used to work in school, so that's what we call it. And, or cross-legged, I guess you could call it. And you sit in it, and because you're in a cabinet that's shut, of course, there's airflow and stuff, it's all dark. So even though you have your eyes closed, it's another level of darkness. And that kind of thing can mess your normal cognitive functions up because your brain is always looking for new stimuli, right? That's why a lot of times when we go into meditation, you start to see things and whatnot, and your brain will randomly come up with different thoughts and stuff because it's trying to fill the void of what's of stimulation or lack thereof. So there's one of those. One thing that I did want to compare this to is, I don't remember what university it is, but there's a university that has a negative sound room. It has all of these sound absorbing panels on the walls. So the decibel level or the sound level is actually negative. And because of that, you don't hear yourself breathing, for example, I think. And there's no outside source of noise. You could actually hear your heartbeat. Like, you know, some people can, like, they can sense it and whatnot on a normal basis, especially if you have anxiety issues and heart palpitations and stuff. But with the sensory deprivation room or the sound deprivation room, because there's no external noise coming in, then your brain starts to make stuff up to fill that void. And people report hearing voices and different things like that because your brain is trying to be like, there's nothing coming in, so I got to make something up. And there's, like, a record of how long people can stay in there before it freaks them out. But this is pertinent to this conversation. So we have sensory deprivation with like things like turning the lights off, or you can even, and this kind of goes along with, you know, the Shroud of Turin and other things, which you can say is a burial shroud, but we can use that in an allegorical fashion where it's more of a sensory overload kind of thing. So you ever see people meditate and they wear those shawls that cover them? I actually have two of them, and they're upstairs. If you've watched my channel, you know that's a joke. I didn't bring one down today because it's kind of hot, and I don't want to overheat while making this video. I'm already in enough pain. So you cover yourself with the shawl, and because you have all this sensory everywhere, it's enclosing your energy. It's keeping it in because you have it covered. And then you can go inwards, go deeper with your meditation in that way, arguably. And what, you know, if you meditate sitting up, you can do it like that. Or, you know, I find meditating to be easier laying down, and I don't know why. I always have since I was 19-ish, and I started meditating because I was in a stress and stress management class for my psychology degree, and that was the subject that I picked, where I found it easier to meditate laying down, probably because I have poor trunk control because of a disability. But give that a try if you haven't. They always say meditate sitting in a chair or sitting crisscross applesauce or whatever. Try meditating laying down. You might get an entirely different experience. But if you cover yourself with a blanket or a shroud, you could call it, or a shawl or whatever, then you have all of this sensory input that is arguably not normal, because we don't walk around completely covered in cloth all day. You're going to bump into walls and stuff, right? But if you do this kind of thing, you might find that your meditation could improve because you're overloading all of your senses. And with that constant input of the weight from the shawl on your face, maybe, or if you're sitting up and you have it over here, the weight of it on your shoulders, even arguably the temperature change. You are overloading your senses, and therefore you're tripping up your brain's normal up, work, home, TV, bed, everyday stuff. And then your brain might not exactly know what to do with all the sensory input it's getting, and therefore you could go somewhere else with your meditation practice. You could arguably go deeper, because what we're trying to do is we're trying to trip up the brain's normal, I got to think about this, I got to think about that, train of thought stuff. You're trying to focus in a different way. You're trying to trick the observer into observing something else. And by doing sensory overload, that just might be the ticket to improving your meditation. So I know this was kind of a short one, but short, sweet, to the point. Give it a try, and if you have tried it, maybe you meditate with a shawl, maybe you meditate with a blanket or whatever, definitely let me know down in the comments, because these videos isn't just me talking to you. This is more of a conversation. So, yeah. Let me know what you think. Questions, comments, complaints, concerns, issues, drop them down below. You can always shoot me an email. Check out my link tree, also in the description, for my books, my classes, my Patreon, my channel membership, all of that good stuff where you can get yourself some books, get yourself some classes, and get yourself some extras. I'll see you next time. Good hunting.